A few minutes given to me to speak, to present the European campaign for the siege in Gaza. One of the organizers of the Freedom Flotilla in 2010, and the European campaign to end the siege on Gaza is an umbrella of 30 associations and NGOs across Europe. As you know, the Israeli blockade is not the first one that's imposed in 2007. There is Israel has a history in imposing and isolating Palestinian territory in West Bank and Gaza Strip. But the last one, this one we are attending and witnessing, is the most severe one. And the situation really, it's become very, very critical with the destruction of tunnels by a new authority in Egypt. And there is a real need to relook how we can challenge this this criminal and illegal blockade, which taking, as my colleague Hanin said before, 1.6 or 7 million people in Gaza and threatening really their life. There is a huge problem in the health sector, in the education sector, and in every really adequate condition to have a standard life, there is a problem. In housing, there is a problem. There is a problem everywhere. So this is really shameful to the humanity to see that. This is a shameful and disgrace to everybody who really free and fight for the right of people. Because, as you know, this blockade has killed already more than 900 people in Gaza, the people who cannot really have access to medicine, to medical care as it has to be. Under international humanitarian law, as you know, Israel remain the occupying power. And it's really its responsibility to ensure and guarantee the welfare for these people in Gaza. Israel, as you know, has failed to guarantee these rights for these people, and really must be held accountable for that crime. And since now 7 years, Israel opposed this blockade, and unfortunately, the new authority in Egypt come to really reinforce that blockade by shutting down all the tunnels, which represent the and represented the only means for these people to really have access to the most need means to still alive and to survive. The blockade is preventing also restriction, as you know, and all the restriction material are prevented to enter in Gaza. And since the attack of Israel in 2008, there is a lot of networks of in Gaza. There is a lot of hospitals, medical center, schools are completely destroyed, and the people there, they are not able at all to reconstruct these networks. This just is small examples of what's going on. As you know, for the time being, more than one third of these people in Gaza, they are without job. The unemployment for these people are increasing, and the expectation for the end of this year, 44% of the total population who able to work will not find any job by the end of the year. So we are speaking about to 300,000 people they are able to work. As you know, the people in Gaza, 50% of the population, they are under 18. years. So this is creating a climate of instability in the region, and Israel must be held accountable again and more for this instability creating by this blockade. We are in the international coalition to end the siege in Gaza, which the European campaign, which I represent, is a member. Since July, we are really witnessing this what's going on. And just last week, we had a call from all our partners to re-meet again and to gather our effort to see how we can how we can give an answer about what's going on, and the reality that the people in Gaza, they don't have any corridor of water, any passage by the sea. It's not at all in accordance with the international law. People in Gaza, they have their water, and they must have an access to be reachable and to reach the world by the water, the sea. Just a few points. I think I crossed my allowed time, but just a few points. We are really need to alleviate this blockade, and the international community is requested really to exercise and pressure in Israel in order to have this blockade, to see this blockade lifted by Israel. And Israel is requested unconditionally to dismantle this blockade without any condition and without any delay. Second, we call on the Israeli government to end the targeting of the innocent people in Gaza and West Bank, which is an violation with the Geneva Convention 1949. Third, we call on the Egyptian government to open the Rafah crossing for people, for circulation of goods, and for without any restriction, to let people really reach this world, because it's the only point who connect now Gaza Strip to the world. Fourth, we call on the international community to address the human rights violation committed by Israel, and to economically exercise a sanction on Israel until it respects the human rights of the population in Palestine. Thank you very much.